introduction. I am really happy to be here and to tell you a little bit about our attempt to understand whether the plants and plant products which we are eating and drinking could affect our human and animal reproduction. It is known that everybody knows that food is influencing our physiology and health as a source of energy, of structural elements, and of regulatory molecules, including enzymes, antioxidants, polyphenols, and other. Usually, the food is influencing this function through endocrine system, through hormones, which in turn are influencing intracellular regulators of cell proliferation, apoptosis, and differentiation. Surprisingly, not very much is known about the influence of food plants on reproduction. Despite the wide consumption of different food plants, there is only very few studies on the influence of these food plants on the reproduction process has been performed. Even less is known about the endocrine and intracellular mechanisms of such actions. Not very much is known what for plants' molecules are responsible for this action, because plants are containing a lot of different biological active substances. And finally, whether this plant could be worse for, could destroy reproduction, and even whether they could be used for improvement of reproductive processes. In our study, we would like to understand whether some food plants like curcuma, turmeric, part of curry powder, green and rooibos tea, ginkgo, flaxseed, yucca, and other, and their components, phytoestrogens and antioxidants, like resveratrol, quercetin, diazin, diazginin, could affect ovarian functions. The second aim is to understand the mechanisms of this action, whether these substances could work through changes in hormone release, in the secretory activity, whether they are influencing cell proliferation, apoptosis, on the response of cells to upstream hormonal stimulators. And finally, whether some of these plants or molecules could be applicable for improvement of reproduction. We have used as a model pigs and rabbits, both living animals and ovarian granulosa cells in the culture. Both animals and cells was subjected to influence of plant extracts, curcumin, green tea, rooibos tea, ginkgo, flaxseed, yucca, some plant molecules, resveratrol, quercetin, diazin, diazginin, hormones alone or in combination with these substances. We have analyzed the basic reproductive parameters, as well also the some markers of proliferation, apoptosis, and secretory activity. In the first series experiment, we have tried to understand whether the plant extracts could affect basic ovarian functions. We have tested curcumin, green tea, rooibos, flaxseed, ginkgo, yucca, and other. It was shown that curcumin, the part of this curry powder, could dramatically reduce ovarian cell proliferation at the level of peptide marker of proliferation, or in the level of mRNA, it means that curcumin is working at the level of both transcription and translation. Curcumin also promotes ovarian cell apoptosis, accumulation of Bucks and of Bucks mRNA in the dose-dependent level. Curcumin could promote the release of steroid hormones, progesterone and testosterone. It means that this curcumin could affect reproduction on different levels, on the level of cell proliferation, apoptosis and secretory activity. Not only curcumin, but also rooibos, ginkgo, flaxseed and green tea was able, like curcumin, inhibit ovarian cell proliferation or to increase the ovarian cell apoptosis. To inhibit the secretion of ovarian leptin, which is considered as the main stimulator of ovarian cell functions. And also the substances was able both down-regulate or up-regulate the ovarian progesterone release. It is known that it means that consumption of some rotten food could really influence the basic ovarian functions, including blocking of ovarian cell proliferation, increase of ovarian cell apoptosis, and changing ovarian cell hormone release, both at the level of peptide and steroid hormones. The next question, what for biological active substances which are containing these plants could influence, could be responsible for this, for these effects? We have tested the most known plant phytoestrogens and antioxidants, resveratrol, quercetin, diosgenin, and diazin, and to compare their effect with the effects of native plants. We have proposed that the similarity of the effects could demonstrate that just these substances are responsible for this plant effect. Resveratrol, like the majority of the tested plants, was able to inhibit proliferation, to promote apoptosis, and to inhibit the release of progesterone. Another antioxidant, quercetin, was also, like the plants, inhibit proliferation, to promote apoptosis. Diosgenin was also was able, in contrast to previous substances, to promote cell both cell proliferation and apoptosis. Diazin also was upregulated both proliferation and apoptosis and inhibited progesterone release. It means that probably resveratrol and quercetin could be just the substances which are responsible for this plant's effect, but not diazin and diosgenin. Previously, we have demonstrated that plants and plant molecules could influence directly basic ovarian cell functions. But it is possible that these substances could regulate not only basic ovarian cell substances, but only the response of these cells to the upstream hormonal regulators. To test this hypothesis, we have tests whether these molecules or plants are able to modify the response of cells to this. And really, datezine was able to block the stimulatory effect of gonadotropin on proliferation, on the release of progesterone and of leptin. Quercetin was also able to inhibit the stimulatory action of FSH and even invert it on ovarian cell proliferation. Resveratrol was also the blocker of the stimulatory effect of gonadotropin on the release of progesterone and testosterone. Curcumin was able to block not only the effects of gonadotropin, but also of the other potent stimulator of ovarian cell function, insulin-like growth factor 1. Green tea also was able to completely block the stimulatory effect of IGF-1 on progesterone release. It means that plants and plant molecules, biological active molecules, are able not only to control the basic ovarian functions, but also the response of ovarian cells to upstream hormonal regulators. Finally, the practical questions. We have understand that different plants could potentially destroy ovarian cell functions, but one of these molecules, one of this plant, yucca, was able to increase, to promote these ovarian functions. We have tests in the special series of experiments whether this yucca could be potentially useful for improvement of some reproductive events. Really, the feeding of rabbit with yucca increased dramatically the conception rate and the kindling rate of animals. This increase in the fecundity was associated with the increase in rabbit reproductive hormones, oxytocin, prostaglandin F, prostaglandin A, and also progesterone, which we have demonstrated previously. Taken together, our experiments suggested that consumption of curcuma, green tea, rooibos, ginkgo, flaxseed could directly suppress ovarian functions by inhibiting of proliferation, by promotion of ovarian cell apoptosis, by alteration is in steroid and peptide hormone release, by blockage of response of cells to upstream hormonal stimulators. This potential negative influence of this feeding and beverage could be taken into account by daily consumption of these foods. Phytoestrogens and antioxidants, resveratrol and quercetin, which are presented in high concentration in different plants, act similar to whole plants. And it is suspected that this resveratrol and quercetin could be just the active components of these plants, which are responsible for these effects. Other phytoestrogens and antioxidants, datezine and diazganine, have both stimulatory and inhibitory effects on ovarian cell functions. They are able to promote both proliferation and apoptosis, suppress progesterone release and response of cells to FSH. So they are also biologically active, but probably they are not responsible for the main food plants effects. Finally, yucca, schildegera could promote steroid and peptide hormone release, both in vivo and in vitro. and also probably through stimulation of reproductive hormones, it could promote the fertility, both conception and kindling rate. So yucca could be a potential plant which could be useful for promotion, for improvement of reproduction process in practice. Finally, I would like to express our gratitude to the colleagues which participated in the obtaining this data. And to you for your attention.
Can I just ask, the beneficial effects that you saw on ovarian function, were they at concentrations which we could achieve from the diet, if we ate these foods in our diet?
Yes, we have performed in vivo experiments only with yucca, and the effect was dose dependent. I think the most efficient dose was really the moderate dose, the physiological dose, not the pharmacological one.
Thank you for a very interesting topic. I just have a question about, because you saw the negative effect of this plant extract on the reproduction system. So in the concentration you used in your study, how comparable with the, because people drink green tea daily and also add curcumin and so on, how comparable the concentration to the we take per day?
We have tried to mimic the concentration which really could reach the cells in vivo, both in vivo experiments and in vitro experiment. So theoretically, the drinking of green tea could be a little bit dangerous, at least over-drinking. Interesting that for some months I have met one of the Chinese specialists in nutrition, which also told about the dangerous over-consumption of green tea, of soya products and other, which could be destroy reproductive process and also could be the one of the causes of growing number of fertility problems in China. So everybody like green tea, including myself, but be careful.
It depends on your age.